obviously the Lakers are not pleased with what they are doing on the floor. I'd like to go back to Anthony Davis's comments when we first joined his presser. He started talking about teammates that were missing shots. That kind of made me straighten up a little bit. I'd love to know what you think, Coach.
Well, look, I'm not going to, as a player, former player and a coach, I'm not going to sit around and point out the shots that guys made. What I'm going to do is think about this game and the fact that I had 18 points and Giannis had 47. Mm. And then Anthony Davis talked about when they move him to the center, they're smaller, he got switched out on guards. Okay. There's a certain point in a basketball game, regardless of what our defensive principle, our defensive scheme is, if I'm guarding a guy. Now, out of Giannis' 47 points, he had 3 threes, mm-hmm. 9 points. Mm-hmm. Let me do my math. Yep. 8 free throws. That's 17, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I mean, he had 30 points in the paint. So let's go back and use a little logic. If Giannis is shooting threes, I'm going to let him shoot all he wants. So I'm going to go under that screen, right? Why am I going over the top on a screen that a guard is set for Giannis? I'm going to go under and make him shoot the three. But the fact that AD to me, 3D, didn't take this game personal, the fact that there is no way I'm switching, I'm running through screens, I'm running over guys, I'm going under, but I am not going to let Giannis without, if he gets 47, all 47 going to be on me because I'm not going to sit there and answer those questions mm-hmm. after the game because that was the matchup that everybody wanted to see. Yeah. Two of the best power forwards, two guys, a complete mirror of each other.
Athletic.
With different skill sets.
Right.
But yet the same.
Yep.
Going at each other. And we saw tonight the difference between the two.
Yes. Similar athletic ability, but not similar motors.
Oh, no. Say that again.
Similar athleticism, not similar motors.
And I think what we're trying to get the Laker fans to understand, we're trying to get the next generation to understand. Giannis is not caught up on, oh, he dunked on you last night. So I was just telling Sam about my son playing the game tonight. He didn't rotate, and the kid dunked it. And he scored a couple points. He wondered why I was mad at him. I said, I don't care if you make 10 threes from half court like me, but the fact that you're not competing, that's what college coaches want to see. That's what we want to see from NBA players every night. And that's why Sam and I was talking, like, wait a minute, LeBron, Giannis, or KD, who would you take right now? And the fact that we're thinking about it, and the way Giannis is playing, that it's the competitiveness. Giannis still is not the best shooter on the court, but he made sure that if AD was not going to challenge him and you were going to switch to pick and roll like all 29 teams do in the NBA now, oh, well, thank you. Let's switch and let me continue to attack the paint.
It blows my mind when you sit in a film session and you go to you get your matchups and you say, this guy's the best guy to guard that guy. And they're not even setting a screen. Watch an NBA game.
Right. These guards don't even want to. Can we show that last? Here you go again. So you're talking about guards,
81 pounds, 85 pounds, setting the screen on Anthony Davis. Really? They just go in there and they slide out the way. Yeah. And these guys are switching because, to me, they don't want to accept that challenge. And it's all, well, I don't want to get in foul trouble. You know what? I'll be sitting on the bench with 6 fouls before I let my counterpart go out there and drop 47.
So here we go. Check it out. Now, look at this. That ain't even a screen! That guy didn't even set a screen!
Can you go under? It's Giannis.
Look at that, look at that, look at that. That's a force down. Come on, Dwight has to step up, right? Just watch. Let's see where a good screen comes. All right, now they're in a little half court trap.
No.
Now, compete.
I'm going to
compete.
Look at this.
Compete.
Now
that was a tough one.
But star players make those shots.
For sure.
Look at that.
Now that one, there was no screen on that one. Now he's mad, he got to get foul called on him. I get that. Okay, I'll give you that one, AD. Okay,
now look at Giannis. Look at this.
And he gets all the way to
power move.
I think the key is Giannis knows his sweet spots, and he gets there.
He knows, but we're trying to get the fans at home to understand that we're not beating up AD. We're just from the old school where we had to fight over screens. Or if a guy couldn't shoot, get under him. He can't shoot, get under him. Not just, hey, switch is coming, switch, and there's never a screen being set. Yeah. If it's a hard screen being set, you switch, we understand that.
Guards, little guards, 6'1", 6'2", 6'3", they may do that one time in an emergency situation. They're going to come and tell you, hey, man, I ain't switching going out. It's not my job. They would tell you because I'm at elbow height. Now, I understand in today's NBA, things have changed. But if you go back to the playoffs, I always say this. It's amazing how come playoff time, Everybody go back to old school basketball. Nobody runs up and down the court and take 53s. Mm-hmm. Everybody's trying to figure out ways to score the easiest they can with each opportunity.